piece. Do you guys think that there's going to be another mercy rule for Tigress's Chi, or will Tigress's Chi finally wake up and shake off these last two negative results and try to get at least one goal or at least one win and avoid the sweep by Mint City? And with that said, I'm going to take a quick break to drink some liquids, because my throat's getting kind of dry, or my tongue's getting kind of dry. That was delicious. So if there's anybody that has started their Saturday night early, I mean, it is 2:20, but if anybody has started their Saturday night early with an alcoholic drink or something, big cheers to you. I'm not drinking alcohol, but cheers. And let's get this started for match 3 of the series. And it looks like Tigress's Chi get the advantage on the kickoff, but Pot of Bread is there to avoid a potential goal. Here comes Slacks with the shot. 12 seconds in, and Mint City Collective have scored the first goal. Nintendo, that was dirty. I saw that, Nintendo. I saw that demo on Tlacuache 89, but it was a good tactic in order to leave the goal wide open for Slacks to score the first goal. And here we go, once again, Nintendo with a tactical demo. I believe that was on, let me see who it was on, because Slacks gets the touch to it, and Nintendo apparently might have been on Cebo213 where he gets the demo, and it's 2-0 now in favor of Mint City Collective. Here's the thing, guys. I know that demos tend to be very, what's the word? So the word in Spanish is polémico, right? But there seems to be a lot of disagreements with Rocket League players regarding the use of demos in a match. And I say this, and here comes a 3-0 win, or a 3-0 goal by Slacks. Takes the ball towards the corner. Julia leaves it right in front of goal. And Slacks takes advantage of that mistake and slots the ball in. But I want to hear your thoughts that are listening right now to the stream. Here comes an opportunity for Tigers, but Slacks gets that save. That's his first save of the game. But thoughts on demos? Is it part of the game, or do you think that is considered toxic behavior? Let us know in the chat. I want to get y'all's opinions on this. But here comes another goal by Slacks. Good dribbling skills, look at that. Takes it over Julian, then puts it up over Cebo, and then it goes past Tlacuache 89 for the fourth goal. I believe that has been all four goals in this match have been by Slacks. And here comes Nintendo with the interception. Shot by Slacks. Gets saved by Julian, but the ball stays in possession with Mint City Collective. Pot of Bread is there to meet it. Takes it all the way to the wing on the left-hand side. Crosses the ball in, but there's nobody to slot it in. Slacks gets a touch on it, but the ball was already past the post and couldn't give it direction on goal. It's still 4-0 with 3:29 left. Here comes another opportunity for Mint City Collective, but it gets saved by the defender. Cebo can't get a touch to clear it out. Here goes another opportunity, Pot of Bread, but Julian clears that ball out, and it looks like Mint City is going to continue to have possession of the ball. Slacks gets it over, and ooh, that was a good push by, I believe that was Julian, because if he hadn't hit, Pot of Bread with a goal. But in that previous play, if Julian had not hit, I believe it was Nintendo or Pot of Bread, but if he hadn't hit him, that was an open goal opportunity. In the end, it still ended up being a goal. But at that time, that was a good decision by Tigress SG. Pot of Bread with the shot. Goes just a little bit wide off of the kickoff. Nintendo and Slacks pinch that ball. It goes over to the right-hand side of the field. Pot of Bread, with his dribbling capabilities, goes past two. Another easy tap-in for Pot of Bread, second goal of the night in three shots. Look at that, goes past I believe it was Tlacuache, and then Julian. There was a demo out in the back of the, or in the middle of the field, 6-0 lead for Mint City over Tigers SG. 2:45 left. I believe there's going to be another mercy rule coming in. So looking over to the chat, but there's another opportunity for Mint City. Oh, Chilena by Nintendo. What a bicycle shot by Nintendo to slot that ball in. It's 7-0 in favor of Mint City Collective. Looking at the chat, talking about controversy. Thank you, El Cubido. Thank you. Controversy is the word I was looking for. So Polska says it should stay in the game, but no team should rely too much on demos and chase the other team around because it is a difficult strategy to execute perfectly through an entire game. I agree, Polska, on that opinion. I honestly think that it is, yes, it's a known mechanic in the game, and if you use it sparingly, oh, that could have been an own goal. But if you use it sparingly, that's fine. But if you rely on demos too much, it might backfire on you, but also it becomes annoying for the other team. And so you really mess up, you know, the atmosphere of the game. Here comes a long shot by Slax from way behind the midfield line. Take a look at that replay, and my phone fell off. That's how wonderful that goal is. It was so amazing. It amazed my phone, and it fell off my desk. But it's 8-0 lead for Mint City Collective in this third match. I have a feeling that Tigers SG has just given up. I don't want to, like, if you saw that kickoff, none of the Tigers SG players went for that. I mean, I personally don't agree with that kind of posture. I mean, while the game is happening, ooh, huge crash between Nintendo and a Tiger SG. Here comes an opportunity for Julian, but it gets cleared out. Nintendo can't get the touch to it, neither does Sibo. Julian does get it, takes it all the way to the left-hand side of the field. Nobody seems to want to go for it. Potabrit is probably just going to dribble it around and just kind of bide their time. And wait for this match to end. I don't think they want to go straight to mercy rule anymore, because here's the thing, that could have easily been another goal for Nintendo. There was nobody out there in the back. Could have easily been a really good long shot. We know that he can do good and accurate long shots, but it seems like they're just kind of letting time by, and they're pretty content with this scoreline. And I guess they don't want to humiliate Tigers SG more than they have to. They already have the result. They already have the sweep. I guess they just don't want to humiliate. And with Tigers SG not giving it their 100% anymore either, I mean, I wouldn't blame them. But Julian with the clearance, and here's a demo by Julian from Slacks. Julian wants to get at least one goal. The consolation goal for Tigers SG. 10 seconds left in this match. Here could be the consolation goal that Julian needed, and Julian gets it. 8-1 for Mint City Collective. Tigers SG just got their consolation goal thanks to Julian, but it is way too little and way too late for Tigers SG, and it's going to be a 3-0 sweep for Mint City Collective against Tigers SG. Final seconds of the match. Potterbread is just now going in reverse. He might have broken a transmission. Gotta take him to the garage. But at the end, it's going to be a Mint City sweep against.